The first vehicle we designed for them was called the Quantum Aggressor. This is a vehicle that's a little bit larger than a golf cart.
Although it is small, it is mighty. This baby puts out 1,700 foot-pounds of torque, which means it can really spin its wheels. It maxes out at 85 miles an hour, or 137 kilometers. But if you crank the wheel at that speed, this puppy will not roll.
This thing is like a rocket.
It's a fuel cell vehicle that runs on electricity and hydrogen. In hydrogen mode, there's a little bit of engine noise, but in electric mode, it's silent. Perfect for doing reconnaissance missions.
They go in, do their mission silently, get out, minimal heat signature, no more than a human body. There are no exhaust emissions from the vehicle, only drinking water. There's like pure water that comes out of the tailpipe.
Hydrogen is the H in H2O, water. Once it passes through the fuel cell, it rejoins an oxygen molecule to become water.
That vehicle can run the equivalent power as 3 households. So you can use it to produce electricity to run all your telecommunications. You can produce heat, hot water, and air conditioning. But the real advantage is the vehicle can be parked inside your tent with you, run all night, and you're going to live in the morning because there are no exhaust emissions from it.
The Aggressor wasn't the only vehicle Allen's company built for the U.S. military.
If you are ready for change, we can start having an energy policy that makes sense. We send $1 billion to foreign nations every single day, and we're melting the polar ice caps in the bargain. That has to change.
These cars that plug into the wall and use even less gas than the hybrids on the road today. America now must import 10 million barrels of oil a day. One group says imports could be slashed by 8 million barrels a day by the year 2025 if every car on the road were a hybrid and half of them were the kind that plug in.
He's Henrik Fisker, and he's building a hybrid supercar. The first glimpse of that car came by way of the UK's Auto Car magazine this week. But you may need a magnifying glass to see it. The small thumbnail image shows a curvy sports car that looks like one of Fisker's Aston designs, though elongated to accommodate an extra door. Fisker says the $100,000 hybrid will be as high as a Porsche 911, but have enough space inside to fit 4 adults and their luggage. He also says the hybrid could cruise in all-electric mode for 50 miles before the gas engine kicks in. Autocar says the first Fiskerized hybrid will go on sale in late 2009, with a debut at the upcoming Detroit Auto Show.
Henrik Fisker's designs from BMW and Aston Martin, and you may have seen the luxury roadsters he's torn apart and rebuilt for super high rollers, like myself. But unless you've been glued to the internets, you haven't seen his new Karma. It's an ultra-luxury hybrid with a gas-electric powertrain. Fisker said the Karma concept will offer high performance, luxury, and the goodness of a hybrid power plant, all for under 6 figures. The concept has claimed 0 to 60 time in 6 seconds at a top speed of 125 miles per hour. And Fisker says his hybrids got financial backing from the company that gave money to little startups called Netscape and Google. So that means this big-ticket hybrid is going to be a little bit more than vaporware. And we also heard it's going to be around $80,000, but that's off the record. And it's going to be in North America in about a year or two.
Joining up with Quantum Technologies, the Fisker Karma looks to be the first of what Fisker Automotive calls its lineup of green vehicles that showcase performance and are built with more eco-friendly methods, meaning it wants people to drive beautiful fast cars that make environmental sense. Concerning the beautiful part, one might mistake the Karma for another manufacturer's vehicle at first glance. The front end looks a bit like a mix of a Corvette and an Aston Martin Vantage, and as you move through the middle and rear of the car, the lines hint of many high-end sports cars, especially the Alfa Romeo C8, only it's leaner, sleeker, and has four doors. No matter what you think it resembles, there's little argument that it looks fast and it looks exotic. So that takes care of the beauty element, but what about being fast and environmentally friendly? It looks like they have a good case for both here. Powered by the Q-Drive plug-in hybrid system, the Fisker Karma is designed to achieve 50 miles of zero-emission, battery-only range with promises of an even more impressive total range of 620 miles when the gasoline engine kicks in. But that's not all. The car will also be offered with an optional roof-integrated solar charging system that will provide power for trickle-charging the batteries as well as for various supplemental cooling tasks. Performance-wise, the vehicle is not as fast as it looks, but it's still pretty respectable. 0 to 60 is achieved in 5.8 seconds with a top sustainable speed of 125 miles per hour. If things go as planned for the Fisker Karma, production will start at the end of 2009 with a surprisingly affordable starting price of $80,000.
New 2010 Fisker Karma, and it's the first of four new models that we'll be coming out with. And what it has is it's called a plug-in hybrid electric vehicle. So you can drive 50 miles on charge on the batteries, and you just plug it into your garage at night, drive to work, drive home, plug it in, and 75 cents a gallon to operate the car in that mode. But then if you want to go on a longer trip, then what happens is the car automatically switches to gasoline electric mode, and then you can drive across the country, so there's no inconvenience. It's a hybrid plus much more. We've designed the car so that you can charge it in at your home. If you have 220 volt, like the Europeans, a lot of countries in Europe have, it takes about 3 hours to charge it. If you have just 110 volt, like here in the United States, it takes a lot longer, probably somewhere in that 6 to 8 hour time frame. We have production is planned for 2009. And we start in late 2009 and then ramp up through 2010 and then to full-scale production in 2011. We've sold all of our 2009. They were special editions signed by Henrik and a serial number and a unique interior. And now we're selling the 2010s. What really sets this car apart, I think, if you look at the design of the car, it is spectacular. And that goes to Henrik Fisker, the famous auto designer of the Aston Martin vehicles, and he was with BMW for many years. So Henrik designed, a stunning four-door sports sedan that looks like a two-door coupe. So I think design, really when it comes down to it, design sells. And number two is you need a technology that can give you, zero emission mode in pure battery electric and then low emission mode in gasoline electric. We're partially owned by General Motors Corporation. We make solar modules for residential, commercial, and solar power plants. But also, if you look at this car, you can see a solar roof on the car from Quantum also. And that solar roof, what it does is it, on a very hot day, keeps the passenger compartment cool. So when you get in the car, it's really not really hot. The other thing is, We forget to realize that this pavement in very hot climates like Phoenix or Los Angeles, that pavement can be radiating 200 degree temperature up underneath that car. So the bottom of your car is hot, and what we have is we have the battery pack running through the middle of the car. So we'll run some little fans just off the solar roof to keep airflow and keep those batteries cool so you optimize your efficiency of the batteries and optimize the performance. We want to get a car to market. There's an opportunity right now with lithium-ion batteries, and of course Quantum also has an interest in a lithium-ion battery company. And we're taking all of our knowledge and learnings from the last few years and having built this same drivetrain in military applications, applying it to this car now and bringing it to commercialization. And it couldn't happen fast enough, because can you imagine with gas, in that $4 price range here in Southern California, if we had this car ready today, we'd be selling them like crazy. Just look at the sales of other hybrid vehicles of any type. The one we all know is the Toyota Prius, and it's a fantastic car. It's a great stepping stone to expanding the whole hybrid market worldwide. I think there are a lot of people, pent-up demand, people with Range Rovers and Jaguars and Mercedes, that they want a high-end luxury commuter car, and this is the car.